Here we are taking the ferry over to Tofino, one of my favorite spots in the entire world to fish. We're gonna be fishing out of Tofino Resort Marina with my good friend Willie Mitchell. We got a fun couple of days planned. We plan on doing some fishing, obviously, maybe some crabbing, some prawning, and to top it all off, it's my birthday, so being able to fish with friends on your birthday is the ultimate gift. But first, we need to fuel up, and I wanna stop at Wildside Grill and grab some lunch.
This is one of my favorite things to eat here. Wildside fish and chips. They're so good. Yeah. I just inhale this stuff. It's so good, man.
After lunch, we're heading down to Tofino Resort Marina. We're gonna meet up with a couple of my good friends at my boat. Fishing reports have been on fire, and there's been some good success over the last couple days.
Billy, what's going on?
Hey, Mo, how are you, bud?
Ready to rock?
Absolutely.
Yeah, go chase some fish here?
Gotcha.
All right. Nice day for it.
Yeah.
I think we should start with a couple spoons to start off. No Bananas is, it's the glow back, and now they make them with the silver back as well. You see this here is Achille McGee, and they've gone to that silver back as well. So. Great spoon, too. You being an Irish guy, Billy McGinnis. McGee, hey, we've got some good synergy here. Hey, buddy. Maybe that's the next one, the McGinnis. Hey?
Maybe.
But, yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it's fine fishing spoons, especially when fishing's hot. You know, bait has its place, too. I mean, I like fishing bait, too, but, you know, if it's a lot of action and you have bait and you're constantly checking it, I mean, sometimes it's easier to just leave it down,
yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
So you're not exchanging gear and wasting time that way. But sometimes they eat anchovies and we'll put them in a teaser head and we'll do that. So we just gotta figure out what they're eating.
You know, when you're fishing at Tofino, there's a couple different ways you approach things. Is one, you can be fishing in tight. We are fishing a little bit shallower water. A lot of times when these salmon are traveling down the outside of the west coast of Vancouver, these fish stay in tight to shore and they hug the rock. So a lot of times you're in tight and you're just following the contour of these islands or these outcroppings to target these fish that are looking for basically protection or some type of shelter in close to these rocks. Fishing in tight, in shallow against the rocks, you know, it gives you a different feel for fishing than you do offshore. When you move in, you're fishing in the rocks, a lot of times you're fishing anywhere from 25 to 60 feet deep. Getting to experience multiple different places to fish along the coast of Tofino is another huge reason why I like to go there. I mean, there are endless spots that you can fish up and down the coast and know you have a very good chance at catching fish.
There we go, fish on. 3 minutes, boys. Oh, I think I might have lost him.
No, he looks like he's there.
No, I don't think so. I felt him pop. Oh, no, he's there.
Something going on.
No. Is he coming right at us?
He might be.
No way. Yeah, he's there. Jesus, that was like a rocket right to us. Haven't seen him yet.
What do we got?
Oh, it looks like a coho. 72 feet.
Hey? I took the No Bananas on the other side.
Oh, there you go. Now you woke
He's
up.
He's running. A little more, Mo. There we go.
Fishing. Look at this backdrop, too. You can turn a little right. Yeah, that's awesome. What a start, man. Perfect fish.
All right, beauty, bud.
Yeah, bud, nice. 3 minutes in, first fish. Let's get the rods down and try and find another one here.
We got into our first fish right away, like literally 2 minutes. And then after that first one, it was nonstop. We had fish consistently for the next couple hours. Tofino is, it really is my happy place. It's just, it's a magical place. It's really tough to describe why or the feeling I get when I think about Tofino. Every time I'm over here, there's a moment or a memory that's created that, you know, will stick with me for my lifetime. There's just something about this place that has a mystical feel to it. It's just raw and real. You never know what's gonna happen.
There you go, got fish on here.
You good?
Yep, he's on. Small one again. Oh, what the hell?
Tiny. Let's double this thing up.
This thing is not big.
Good, bad, or ugly. Right here, look at this.
Oh my God! Are you kidding me? That was sick, dude.
Did it do that for your birthday?
Oh my God.
Did it do that for your birthday?
My heart is in my throat right now.
Come on, do it again, buddy.
Oh my God. That was 75 feet from the boat. Yeah. That's a rockfish, man. He's close too, dude.
Oh!
He is throwing sideways his tail. He's like launching out on that bait probably, hey? Oh, look at that. That is wicked. Look at that.
What a show.
How many has he ripped off? He's done about 15 of those. So loud too.
Look at him, he's right here. He's on his back.
Now he's saying hi with the flipper.
This is the ultimate show right here. Look at this thing. Are you kidding me? Oh, dude. This is one of the best whale shows I've ever seen.
Slapping their tails to drive the fish down below and bubble net them, capture them, and away
or
they go.
Or even sometimes I've read like stunning fish too, right?
Right.
Stun fish and come back. But that was incredible. For how long you did it for?
4 minutes of tail slapping. Spank it.
That was unreal. Never seen anything like that.
Well, good way to spend your birthday.
Well,
don't see that every day.
You do not see that every day. You don't see that every 10 years.
Right.
1975, 76, 74.
1975, yeah.
Yeah, this it's day, 1975, what happened, Mo?
It was the year of the whale. Big birthday. The whale just came to say hi.
Yeah, I think he did.
That's a pretty cool birthday gift. We're into one. You got him?
Come on, fishy, fishy.
Oh, I got one right here. Oh,
right there.
There we go. That's a better fish, I think.
That was a nice hit.
Oh, there we go.
Nice.
That's the sound we like to hear.
Nice.
Look at him thrashing on the surface.
Oh,
he's off.
Oh, you just lost him.
Just spit the hook on the surface, just rolling. Son of a gun. Keep that speed, Todd, it's fine. Better fish, too, again.
All right, Mo, because it's your birthday, I thought I'd cook you dinner out here. I brought a little bit of moose sausage to start.
A little sunset dinner?
Yeah, sunset dinner.
Nice.
I got some moose sausage in here. I've got some all beef harvest hot dogs, mustard relish ketchup. We got Pete's Mountain Meats, apple mango chutney sausage, buns already buttered, and homemade Caesar sauce to put on them.
Hold on, pre-buttered buns and homemade Caesar.
Absolutely, bud.
Is the homemade Caesar secret recipe, or can you tell us what goes into that?
It's pretty secret recipe.
Okay, fair enough. I'm looking forward to this, bud. Look at this, fully
prepared. Look at those bad boys. Those are some good sausage.
Wow.
These right here, wait till you taste those, Mo.
One of the things that Billy is truly known for is he is a chef on the water. He is legendary for his preparation of meals and bringing his food on the boat and lighting his barbecue and cooking breakfast sandwiches, cooking bratwurst out there. And I'm not talking just your standard bratwurst with a bun. He has a variety of options that you can put on, you know, different kind of buns, different type of mustards. He's got spicy, he's got regular, you know, he's got different type of cheeses. any fisherman who's been on the water for a long period of time, if they're able to get a nice hot meal when they're out there, they are so appreciative. He truly is the chef on the water in the West Coast.
Oh, that's a dinner at Champions right there.
Todd, oh.
Right on. Thanks, that buddy.
Smells so, you betcha. Yeah. Thanks, pal.
You betcha. Ooh. High seas heaven right here.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome, Billy. You nailed it, bud. You nailed it.
Hey?
Perfect.
End of the first day for a birthday. I mean, I don't know how you can draw it up much better than this. To be out here on the water with my buddies and just fishing, you know, 10 minutes from the dock with the backdrop of Tofino and the coastal mountains. I mean, geez, it doesn't get any better. Great first night, great birthday. Really looking forward to getting on the water tomorrow with Willie and going on a bit of an adventure, doing some prawning and crabbing. Early the next morning, heading back down to Tofino Resort and Marina to meet up with my good buddy Willie, get our crab traps ready, prawn traps ready. We're gonna be heading out on Willie's boat, king size. I like to refer to it as a rocket ship with triple 300 Mercs on the back. This is like boat on steroids. And he drives it like that, like it's a race car. It is paddle to the metal and hair straight back, and this thing covers water in a hurry.
We gotta christen these things. We're gonna go do a little prawning, a little crabbing, and then a little fishing.
Forage day.
It's almost like the Tofino Grand Slam. Prawns, crabs, and salmon.
Seriously, right? Then we'll grab those crab bags and start dialing those in.
Just a tanuan, cut a piece off. This is probably the ultimate bait for crabbing here.
We'll see.
A lot of people wouldn't think about it, but that tuna is obviously super, super oily fish. Should be perfect for what we're trying to do here, get these crab. You want some more in there?
Sure. Yeah, there we are. That'll do it.
One thing that comes to my mind when I think about Willie is the word passion. You know, he likes to have a lot of fun, but he's a super passionate guy. You know, obviously had a tremendous hockey career, and I think his true passion is fishing and being on the water, and he's really dedicated his time and energy now to conservation and enhancement in the Tofino area. But he's really embraced the ocean lifestyle. He's always pushing limits, and he's always trying to be a bit of a pioneer out on the water. But the main thing is he likes to have a good time, he likes to have fun, and it's always fun to be around guys like that.
So you got a couple go-to spots, and then we'll try a couple new spots,
yep.
Right?
Yeah. Personally, I just like back here because it's less pressure.
Yeah, not many people are
coming to town. And I only know these spots because, for me, when I have visitors in from town, out of town, I come up here and do like a bear watch. And so it's kind of just handy. I just throw it in the area, I do the bear watch, and then pick them up on the way back. Yeah. And then I go back to the restaurant and do a little cook your catch, right? Have some fresh crab with some fries and a beer, and it doesn't suck.
That's yeah. Healthy.
And if you're not from here, right, and you're doing that, it's killer day, right?
I mean, even spending a lot of time here and getting a chance to do that still blows your mind.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah,
it never gets old.
No, I'm super lucky I get to do it all the time, and I'm just like, yeah.
50 feet here.
Two more, bud. Two more.
Yeah. Trying to keep some efficiency here. Load these up while Mo's getting the crab traps out, and then drop the prawn traps here all in one.
Last one. We'll be on to prawning here in a minute. Last one. There you go. We're in. Operation Spot Prawn.
Little spot prawn special in this one.
All right. There she blows.
Albacore head and all.
You know, crabbing in Tofino can be fantastic. I guess it's like any other shellfish or fishery, is these crabs do move around, you have to find them. But it's an awesome thing to be able to go out, drop traps, provide for yourself and your family and friends, and really get to enjoy kind of the succulent sweet meat of a Dungeness crab if you pair that with a fish or even spot prawns from back here. I mean, you're just spoiled.
What's your call in there anyways?
What's that?
How many you got in there?
I think we have
three keepers?
I'm thinking I'm gonna go four.
How deep do you have this one?
This one's deep, bud, like 95 feet. Give me the deep one, huh?
Go to the basement.
Well, there she is.
It's loaded.
Old hot tuna.
Oh, a couple in. I don't know. It's close.
Close?
One keeper for sure. See the shape there? The female kind of has more of a heart shape there on her abdomen. Right in here. Males. This one is a keeper.
That one you see like the gold color, so it's actually lots of meat in the shell. The white ones, obviously, they've just taken on a new shell and it tends to be less meat in them. How many are in there? Two?
Two keepers.
We'll get plenty. So this one, even though it's a keeper, we'll let them go.
This feels heavier. Unless I'm just pulling it against the water.
Couple in there.
Couple keepers.
I think so.
It's cool to see the different colors too, eh?
Nice one.
Like look at that one there, then look at the shell of this one, eh? Like the purple shell. Like,
yeah.
See how purple that is there?
Yeah. Darker shell, for sure. This one's just new.
And the key thing too with crabs, as you know, is how hard the shell is, right? You don't want a soft underbelly, so you can push that in there and see how hard that is.
Totally.
Spa.
Spa.
Go marinate in the spa for a little while.
Now we're gonna zip back in, park Willie's boat. We're gonna get on my boat, Real Season. We're gonna head out and do a little bit more salmon fishing. Willie's a very good salmon fisherman. You know, he's grown up doing it his whole life, but he's so particular when he's on the water. He's a purist cut plugger when it comes to fishing, or a holy roller, but it's always a constant game between him and I of give and take of what we're trying to do on both sides. And we're both competitive, but the main thing is we just like to have a good time on the water, man. That's what it's all about. I mean, I love to catch fish, absolutely. But when you think back about your time on the water, it's really about, okay, who am I hanging out with? Did we have a good time that day? Were we laughing? Were we joking? Those are the things you remember as time goes by. And that's why I like fishing with Willie.
Has there ever been a day in your life when you fished without putting together a whole herring?
Well, a cut plug, but never not a herring, no.
Fish on. Didn't take too long.
Drop this down and double up.
Yeah, exactly. Get her. The fish are a little bit deeper, I think.
Yep.
Fish on. That took 5 minutes tonight. Last night it was three. Here he is.
We need a harvest here for the table.
Skinny G again, eh?
Yeah.
The net's on top here. That clips in the water, so you can watch it. Oh, are you freaking kidding me?
Ah, you know what? Be another one. Are you freaking?
That's fishing. That is fishing.
Hey, you know what? It's all right. It wasn't the biggest fish you ever caught. I'll guarantee you that.
You switching up?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Bait's bait.
Yep.
That looks better.
Fish on, here we go.
I'm not even in, Mo. You want to put neutral?
No, you're fine.
Keep it in gear?
Yeah, unless you want to get your rod in.
No, I'm fine.
Hold on a sec.
Keep walking back. I don't know if it's...
Got him?
Yeah.
Fish on, fish in. There we go. Cook your catch, eh? Chef Paul Moran tonight.
Yeah.
Got the crabs. We're going to go pull the prawn traps.
Let's hope we got some prawns.
I think
we're going to be eating like rock stars, that's for sure.
That's healthy living right there.
Yeah. Minutes to the table. Yeah. With some love.
Everything 10 minutes from the dock here.
Yeah.
Right from the resort. Yeah. Fino Resort Marina.
Yeah. Pretty cool.
Ew.
Well, Willie and I managed to catch a couple more salmon today. It was a lot of fun out here in the water. We didn't even fish all that long, but we came out and did what we had to do. And now it's time to head back in, switch over to his boat, and go pull our traps. I know there's options out there for pulling your traps, but Willie and I truly believe that pulling traps should be like a labor of love, a real physical thing where you have to experience some pain while you're pulling these traps up. It's kind of like the hunter-gatherer mentality. Like the work you put in at the end of the night, it's gonna taste that much better.
So, two.
Well,
cheers.
Buddy, let's celebrate, eh? Little appetizer here before the meal.
Cheers.
Hey? Oh, it'll be good. It'll be like candy.
There's a lot of labor, a lot of love that went into that here.
We pulled 800 feet of rope for these two guys.
Yeah, cheers.
Cheers, man.
They are good like that.
That'll keep you coming back. Mm-hmm. We didn't have as much luck with the prawns, but that's fishing, right? Some days you get fish, some days you don't. Well, some days you get prawns, some days you don't. Once again, we had another spectacular trip in Tofino. From the fishing, to the crabbing, to the prawning. I mean, if you really think about it, there's very few places in the world that offer what British Columbia and the West Coast have to offer. On the water, catching multiple fish, crabbing, prawning, being able to bring our fish in to have a meal prepared for us, like a first-class meal prepared for our group. And the hospitality of Tofino Resort Marina. And these are the things you look back on as the years go by, and they stick out in your mind as experiences that, you know, you're very fortunate and very lucky to have. Thanks to my good friend, Willie Mitchell. He's part of the ownership group here at Tofino Resort Marina. He was very gracious in hosting us. This trip just reaffirms my love for Tofino and the entire West Coast. Thank you.